Hi guys, welcome back. This is part 6. In this video, we're going to attach the arms and we're also going to add the legs that help the mouse stand up on its own. So let's get your yarn needle and your crochet hook and let's get started. Alright guys, now we're going to add the arms, and the arms are fairly simple to do. The only issue would be working in such a small chain, but honestly, it's pretty simple. The way I show you how to do it, if you find doesn't work out for you, don't worry about it. What you can do is just make a chain and then sew the chain to the mouse and problem solved. But I'm going to show you how to add the chain arms right onto the mouse so you don't have to sew anything onto it. So you start off with a strand of yarn the same color as your mouse. Make your strand way too long. So this is going to be the arms of the mouse, and of course I'm going to be cutting off quite a large chunk of that, but I like to work with something that's too long than something that's too short. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring the yarn strand through the mouse right up where you want the arms to be. So right through the top of the mouse like that, bring it through and pull the one yarn strand through and leave the other one hanging on the other side. Okay, and on the one arm, the one with your yarn needle still attached to it, knot it off here. So just go through right beside where the yarn strand is coming out of. Go right beside there, make a loop, and then go through that loop. So pull it through, and then we're going to go through that loop. Okay, so now we can make the chains. Now the yarn tails can't be pulled out of there. Now we can go ahead and make the chains. And it doesn't matter which arm you start with. I'll just start with this one here. I'm going to take my crochet hook and go right underneath that knot. Right through the body. And go right underneath where that yarn tail is coming out of. Then I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it through. Now yarn over and pull through that loop on your hook. There was one. I'm going to make a chain of four. That was one, two, three, and four. And that's it. And now you pull the yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. Now we're going to thread our yarn needle again. And we're going to make the little hand at the bottom. And we make the hand just by wrapping the yarn. So you want the hand to be a little bit thicker than the chain. So just take your yarn needle now and go right through the chain, right at the very end, and wrap it. And I'm going to do this three times. So there was one, two, and three. I just find that three makes the hand big enough. So now we'll take the yarn tail and we're going to weave it in and out up to the top of the arm. So in and out of the chain, all the way to the top of the arm. Okay, so when you get to the top, you might have to pull the arm down because it might scrunch up the arm. But there we go. So now if the arm is flaring out, like this one, I didn't bother tacking the arm down. It's kind of like doing its own thing there. This arm here is in a permanent waving position because the way I pulled the yarn tail in the back, it pulled the arm up there. And I thought, oh, that's cute. So I thought I'd just leave it there. So I knotted off. I could bring the arm down, but it naturally wants to go up here. So you can do the same, or you can have the arms going down beside the body. So now I'll take the yarn and I'll just wrap it. I'll go right through the top of the arm and go into the body and out through the back. And usually just once is enough. You see it tacks the arm right down. But once you're happy with the arm, then you just knot this off in the back. So see where the yarn tail is coming out of? I'm going to go right beside there with my yarn needle, make a loop, and then go through that loop. And then pull. And now let's knot it off. Now I'll get rid of this yarn tail by bringing it through the body, out through a stitch hole, just anywhere away from that area. Pull on it slightly and cut. So one arm is done. Now we'll go ahead and do the other arm, and we're going to do the same thing all over again. Go underneath where that yarn tail is coming through, pull the yarn through, yarn over and pull through that loop four times. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we'll make the hand, and I'm going to wrap around the end of that arm three times.
1, 2, and 3.
And then weave in and out of that chain, go to the top of the arm. Alright, so before you knot anything off, just make sure that you're happy with how the arms look, and if they're flaring out, like I said, you can tack them down with your strand of yarn. Once you're happy, just knot off. And then go through the body. Alright, so let's add the legs now. And the legs are actually way more simple than the arms even. But they do help the mouse stand up. But the ones without legs will just pretty much just be like a weeble wobble and fall over. So these little legs that I've added here do help. You can barely see them. A strand of yarn the same color as your mouse. So here's the magic ring that we started off with. That's the loop with 6 stitches, and then there's the second row right here, and I've wrapped the yarn around the second row. So I'm going to go in between the second and third row, or the first and second row. You can go up like this, or you can go down, doesn't matter. I think I want my first leg right there, so I'll pull the yarn through. So the one yarn tail is just going to be hanging, so just hang on to it so it's out of your way, and that chain tail as well. And now we're just going to wrap. I think I wrapped 5 times, so I'm just wrapping around that row. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I think 5 should do it. And now I'll go up one more time, and I'll bring the yarn needle over right about there, right where I want the other foot to go. And I'll do the same thing. Wrap here about 5 times. 1, and you will have to shape it a little bit with your fingers. That is normal. And there we go, he stands up pretty good. So now we want to knot these yarn tails off, so I'm going to bring this to the back. And I'll knot it off just like I've done the other ones. The same with this one. So we're almost done. That's the end of this video. The video is getting a little bit long, so I think we'll add the eyes and a couple more details in the next video. So we'll end it here, and we'll just see you in the next video.